From the Channel3000.com Alert Center, this is News 3 Now at 10.
Thanks for joining us tonight. Political activist and Black Panthers co-founder Bobby Seale is in Madison. He spoke tonight at Madison College.
Beforehand, he held a book signing event and met with members of the media talking about his civil right work.
I took my work to heart. And that's the way I was. And when I started organizing, I'm going to deal with all the particulars, et cetera. I'm going to research, et cetera.
Tonight, he spoke about his experiences in the civil rights movement and how he was inspired by Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Seale gained prominence when he was arrested, being blamed for inciting a riot outside the Democratic National Convention in 1968.
Tonight, Leopold Elementary School in Madison is honoring its students with a Black History celebration. Madeline O'Neill tells us how organizers say positive events like this can help tackle heavy issues within the district. Maddie?
Well, MMSD has a Black Excellence Initiative working to find equitable solutions to issues like the achievement gap. With recent statistics showing Black students report feeling less safe and less like they belong than white students, organizers say events like tonight's are more important than ever.
It's good. Right?
At Leopold Elementary's annual Black History Celebration, Gibson is one of a handful of students receiving an award.
Nervous.
She's in kindergarten, and I think she just like encouraged other students to do their best, right?
We celebrate the smallest, and that will, you know, make it expand to be something great.
Sonia Valley, an art teacher at the diverse school, says no accomplishment is too small to recognize.
We want to make sure our children know that knowledge is what makes us strong.
And our kids sometimes don't see themselves as much reflected in the community and mainstream.
Community schools resource coordinator Rosie Geaton says positive community events like this can help overcome the negativity.
So this is one of the efforts that we put together for them to see that we highlight culture, we care about you, we know what background you're coming from. And so I think it gives them a sense of, oh, so I can see myself as well. I know that I'm valued as well.
When it comes to issues of racial inequity, they say even small steps move you forward.
I've been at Leopold School for a while, and I'm still here believing that change will come and the future will be bright for us.
I think as a child, you need to know who you are. And I think this is a good time to figure that out, right?
Yes.
Now, Black community leaders are criticizing the district's choice for the new superintendent. Some are worried Matthew Gutierrez won't have the background necessary to address some of the concerns of Black students. Now, Gutierrez, unanimously approved by the school board, takes over as superintendent on June 1st.
Madeline O'Neill reporting tonight. Maddie, thank you.
And let's get a look at our first warm forecast. Now, here's Chief Meteorologist Gary Kenalty.
Well, temperatures will be on the cold side for the next couple of days, but we're missing that winter storm down to the south. We're just getting the winds from it. Time lapse from the WIC SkyCam shows mostly cloudy skies through the day. Occasionally, there'll be a little peak of sunshine coming on through, but for the most part, skies have just been mostly cloudy, but there's been very little snow anywhere near here. There's been some light snow over southeastern Wisconsin, seeing visibilities dropped around 4 miles in Kenosha, but other than maybe a few flurries in Rock and Walworth County, the snow is pretty much staying to our south and east. Temperatures will drop off into the middle 20s by tomorrow morning. The cloud cover will keep us from falling too fast, but it'll also keep us from rising very much tomorrow. Look for a high of 30 degrees, maybe a couple of afternoon flurries. Cold weather will stick around through Saturday, but a warm-up's on the way for next week. I'll tell you how mild it'll get in a few minutes.
Gary, thank you. The 21-year-old suspected of killing a Blue Mounds veteran will head to trial now. At his initial court appearance today, we learned new details about the charges against Riley Berg. According to the medical examiner, Nicholas Day was out jogging in the middle of the day when he was struck by a bullet fired from a high-powered rifle. It hit him in his back. The doctor testified the gunshot shattered his hip, exited his body. It may have been survivable, but his alleged attacker then cut his throat multiple times. A UW hospital patient called for action after his car was stolen after he checked it in with a hospital valet. Ted Myers called our call for action line saying he was there for chemo treatment, got the valet, slipped from the attendant, went inside, but when the attendant went to help another driver, thieves took off in Myers' car. No one realized for hours. Myers feels the hospital is responsible, but says all he was given was two $5 gift cards to the gift shop.
I did get I'm so sorry this happened, and you know, they gave me gift cards.
But yeah, that was pretty much it. Just a sorry, and they didn't offer me a ride home or ask me how I was getting home or anything.
So that incident happened 6 weeks ago. For most of that time, UWPD has known who the thieves are. They say it's Misty Schramm and William Taylor. Officers have exhausted all of their resources but haven't been able to locate them. They are hoping the community can help.
Attorney General Josh Call says Wisconsin has joined a multi-state investigation into Juul Labs and the company's marketing and sales practices targeting kids. The investigation will look into Juul's statements about nicotine content, risks, safety, and effectiveness as a smoking cessation device. The Middleton Cross Plains School District staff member who allegedly separated students by race during a test in October is resigning. The teacher, who has not been identified, will resign effective June 30th. They will remain on paid leave until then.
An Arkansas man is accused of trying to blow up his vehicle outside the Pentagon. He was in federal court today. According to court documents, a Pentagon police officer spotted the 19-year-old standing next to a vehicle with a lighter. This was yesterday. The officer says he was trying to light a piece of fabric that was hanging from the vehicle's gas tank on fire. 7 Democratic presidential candidates square off in South Carolina. This is just days before the state's primary, a debate co-hosted by CBS News.
Competitors tried to slow the momentum of frontrunner Bernie Sanders. CBS's Natalie Brand is in Charleston.
I'm hearing my name mentioned a little bit tonight.
Right from the start, Bernie Sanders took fire from all sides.
Let's talk about
what
it adds up to.
Let's talk about math.
Let's talk about math indeed. Okay, I'll tell you exactly what it adds up to. It adds up to 4 more years of Donald Trump.
The senator from Vermont recently emerged as the front runner among Democrats, especially after Saturday's commanding victory in Nevada, a win that's prompted new scrutiny of his record.
Walking distance here is Mother Emanuel Church. 9 people shot dead by a white supremacist. Bernie voted 5 times against the Brady Bill.
Polls show Joe Biden with a slight edge in South Carolina, but the former vice president needs a strong showing in Saturday's primary to catch up in the delegate count.
If you don't win South Carolina, will you continue in the race?
I will win South Carolina.
This was also the final debate before Super Tuesday, just 1 week from now, when 14 states will vote, contests that will no doubt narrow the field.
Progressives have got one shot, and we need to spend it with a leader who will get something done.
You have to learn how to work with both sides of the aisle, and then you can get stuff done.
We need a campaign of energy and excitement. We need to have the largest voter turnout in the history of the United States.
A CBS News poll finds defeating President Trump is a top priority for South Carolina Democrats, but less than 50% of voters are confident Democrats will nominate a candidate who can do that. Natalie Brand, CBS News, Charleston.
54 delegates are at stake in the South Carolina primary. No candidates have dropped out of the race since Sanders' big Nevada win over the weekend.
Due tonight, Senator Tammy Baldwin is asking the Trump administration to take immediate action to support Wisconsin's hardwood businesses and the lumber industry. In a letter, she says the ongoing trade war and retaliatory tariffs from China are hurting local workers.
These hardwood products actually do have a certain amount of time during which they have to be processed or they will become waste wood. I think also we've seen China switch from purchasing hardwood from the United States to relying on other countries, which means those markets may not come back to us.
Former food company executive Michelle Janovs was sentenced to 5 months in prison today. It's in connection to the College Admissions scandal. According to the U.S. Attorney's Office in Massachusetts, Janovs, whose family invented Hot Pockets, paid the scheme's mastermind $100,000 to cheat on 2 of her daughter's ACTs and agreed to pay $200,000 to have one of the daughters admitted to the University of Southern California. What was supposed to be a family portrait to remember nearly turned into a tragedy. The Pennsylvania family was posing on railroad tracks when a train came barreling towards them. No one was hurt in this case, but officials say it serves as a good reminder to pay attention when approaching train tracks, no matter if you are in a car or on foot.
New tonight, the Centers for Disease Control says Americans should prepare for the spread of coronavirus within the United States. In a press call today, officials with the CDC say it's a matter of when, not if, the new strain of this disease starts to spread in communities within the U.S. UW-Milwaukee has asked 2 students studying abroad in South Korea to return to the U.S. now. The university says the students are not in an area where travel is restricted and there is no reason to believe they have been exposed to coronavirus. They say this is just a precaution after Florida, the CDC issued a level 3 advisory for South Korea, advising travelers to avoid all non-essential travel there. And some bad news today for a local middle school robotics club that was preparing for a trip to Japan this summer. That event has been canceled due to coronavirus fears. The Beaver Dam robotics team was going to be one of just 7 U.S. teams going to this international competition. The team says, as of now, they are waiting to hear if they'll be going to a reassignment in a different location for that competition.
The Wisconsin Department of Natural Resources is conducting an investigation into the illegal shooting of 2 bald eagles. They were shot near Antigo. The eagles were initially admitted to the Northern Wisconsin Bird Rehabilitation Center, but both died. Governor Tony Evers today announced a $29 million Harbor Assistance Program grant for improvements needed at the Port of Marinette. Marinette Marine uses that port. The company has been contracted by the U.S. military for years, building the latest warships. The governor says these shipyard improvements ensure that Marinette Marine can continue to compete for U.S. naval contracts and provide the area with good-paying, family-supporting jobs.
Major housing development is officially coming to the city of Janesville now. Construction on the River Flats apartment complex could start as early as next week, meaning it could be done a little more than a year from now. This is a 92-unit affordable housing complex, and it fills an immediate need for this community, which has a vacancy rate between just 1% and 2%. The village of Monticello is about to have broadband internet for the first time ever. Spectrum installing broadband for the rural community. People there feel they are being held back by not having access to good internet service. They hope this will change that. And the move is part of a bigger project for Spectrum. They're starting in Monticello, but they say they also plan to put broadband cables in Orfordville and Footville. Still to come tonight at 10, your first warm forecast. Most of southern Wisconsin dodges today's snowstorm.
Plus, a party like no other with a Midwest connection. Stay with us.
Chunk Gaming Madison. Tom, people are loving this place.
They sure are, Jerry. Let's go see who Tina's chatting with now.
Thanks, guys. Looks like we have some beautiful ladies joining us. What are you up to tonight, girls?
Girls' night.
We're getting some drinks.
I want to win that car.
Sounds great. Are you feeling lucky? What's your favorite slot machine? to you guys.
Looks like those ladies are on a mission.
Oh, it's about to go down.
Chunk Gaming Madison.
Built for your next adventure, it's the 2020 Subaru Crosstrek Premium at Don Miller. With symmetrical all-wheel drive, the Crosstrek has vehicle dynamics control and EyeSight driver assist technology. Lease the Crosstrek Premium, $239 per month plus tax, 36 months, 10,000 miles per year, no security deposit, $1,939 due at signing. Get all-wheel drive plus MPG. The 2020 Crosstrek Premium at Don Miller Subaru, West on Odana or Eastside, High Crossing Boulevard, Madison.
Don Miller.
At Papa Murphy's, we're making flavor magic for just $9. Introducing the new Combo Magnifico, a magical combination of giant pepperoni, sausage, mushrooms, and onions, all for just $9. Bake it yourself, then make it disappear. We make it, you bake it, Papa Murphy's.
You know who really loves fresh food? Amateur chefs, stay-at-home parents, salad lovers, barbecuers, smorgasborders, hors d'oeuvres, fondueurs, and flambeers, oh, midnight snackers, brown baggers, bakers, and throw it in the microwavers. At Pick and Save, you can get all the fresh you want at a great price with same day pickup and delivery. Because we believe in fresh for everyone.
So if you can find me.
Wicked, the untold true story of the Witches of Oz, flies back to Overture Center, March 11th through the 29th only. Visit Overture.org to get wicked.
The things we do for the ones we love. People are amazing. We're here to help keep them that way. Unity Point Health Meritor, a partner of UW Health. Know how much you matter to this world.
Hi, everyone. Wednesday morning, we'll be breaking down everything you need to know from the Democratic debates and looking ahead to what's next.
And if you celebrate Ash Wednesday, you can now do it without getting out of your car. We'll tell you how starting at 4:30.
See you then.
Welcome back. Artists of all ages have work on display tonight. The Richardson School partnered with Edgewood College to display the artwork of students with special needs. One piece called The Eye Project featured pieces from students from both groups and a spot for the public to add as well. The goal is to appreciate and support art.
Art is just a universal language. Anyone can participate, anyone can do it. It doesn't take a whole lot of effort, or it can if you want it to. And so from college students studying art to our third and fourth graders who are just starting to learn art, everyone can do it and participate.
The display will be hung through this Friday, February 28th.
All right, let's take a live look. This is Bourbon Street, downtown New Orleans right now. The party expected, of course, to continue well into the night. Thousands celebrating the end of the carnival season there. And today, also known as Fat Tuesday, of course, the final touch to weeks of celebrations, parades, and merriment. Carnival season started January 6th, ends Fat Tuesday, Mardi Gras. Of course, the biggest celebration New Orleans hosts every year, the magnificent costumes, beaded and feathered party laced with tradition. But most of all, it's all about having a good time. And in parts of the Midwest, including right here in Madison, people celebrate Punschke Day, the traditional Polish pastry filled with fruit or custard and coated in sugar. They're eaten on Fat Tuesday as an indulgence before the beginning of Lent. It has been a European tradition going back to the Middle Ages, making them a way to use up all those ingredients in a pastry before the Lenten fasting season gets underway.
I admit that I had a little bit
in the newsroom. We had a whole bunch of those in the newsroom today. Mm-hmm.
Nobody told me about it.
Whatever, Gary. You know. It happened.
See? I'm always the last to know these things.
I think there might be some king cake left in there, too.
Yeah, well,
just saying.
How much time
have
we got?
A little crunchy, Gary. Might be a little crunchy by now.
Well, at least we've missed out on the snow, so it's been a quieter day in the weather office, even if I couldn't get my punschke. Time lapse from the Queen Bee Radio Skycam in Platteville shows cloudy skies for much of the day. Every once in a while, a peak of sunshine came through, but that was pretty much about it. But these clouds are from the storm system that missed us to the south, but also is drawing down colder air across much of the Midwest. Three things you need to know in the forecast is that the cold weather will stick around through Saturday. Highs will be around 30 for tomorrow, 20s for Thursday and Friday, and then low 30s for Saturday. But the 40s return on Sunday and last through much of next week. In fact, other than Wednesday, I have high temperatures at or above 40 degrees all the way through the following weekend. And some rain showers are possible Monday and Tuesday. The next weather system will be warm enough for just that. Winter weather advisory is still in effect for parts of the Chicago area into northern Indiana, southern Michigan. That's with the snow that continues to wind down over there. But in southeastern Wisconsin, some light snow in Racine and Kenosha counties. There might be a flurry that makes it about as far northwest as maybe southern Dane County at some point tonight, but don't expect it. You can see visibility is obviously at or above 10 miles here, but 2 mile visibility with some light snow being reported in Kenosha. And as we check out temperatures right now, they're mainly in the 20s across the state. Milwaukee's still at 32, as is La Crosse, but you can see on WeatherTrack, upper level winds are still from the southwest. We've got just a brief shot of colder air coming in from the northwest. This bulge in the jet stream also means that the air is starting to dry out. So we've got several days of quiet weather before a weather system out in the middle of the Pacific Ocean moves eastward, warms us up early next week, and then brings us some rain from Monday into Tuesday. But the current weather map shows that the main area of low pressure right now is located near Cincinnati. This trough of low pressure extending back to the west is kind of what's drawing out that large area of precipitation. This is what we were thinking last week. We'd see a weather system like this. It was just kind of drawn out. Not a lot of heavy snow in there, but light to occasionally moderate snow, and just kind of moving over the same general area. But that area, instead of being up here, has been down to our south. Now it's the cold air that's starting to come in from the north, and that's what will dominate our weather over the next couple of days. You can see on Future Track, cloudy skies for tonight. Tomorrow, might even see a couple of flurries pop up in the afternoon. Shouldn't amount to very much. Then as we turn partly cloudy for tomorrow night, that will allow temperatures to drop off into the middle teens. On Thursday, look for variably cloudy skies. High temperatures will top out in the probably the middle 20s. And then Friday, we'll start out with generally clear skies in the morning. That will allow temperatures to start in the single digits, and then high temperatures will be in the mid-20s. Some clouds farther out to the west start moving in our direction, but also the winds start becoming a little more southwesterly, and that will start the warm-up, especially as we head into the latter part of the weekend. So for tomorrow, look for mostly cloudy skies, perhaps a couple of flurries popping up in the afternoon, otherwise breezy. Our high temperature at 30 degrees, and as we look at the 7 to 10-day forecast, those temperatures remain cold through Saturday, but at least the weather stays quiet. Sunday will warm up with breezy southwesterly winds, and then temperatures will be in the low 40s with some rain showers Monday and Tuesday. Might end as mixed of rain and snow. snow late Tuesday night into Wednesday, and then some quiet weather for the end of next week. High temperatures in the lower 40s Thursday and Friday, and even into the following weekend, I think we'll probably still be at or above 40.
That'll be really nice.
And we'll also be in March, too.
That's true. That's true. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks, Gary. Verona boys hockey team going full speed ahead into the sectional finals. I'm a little biased. I've known some of these guys since they were little guys. But we're going to check out some highlights coming up next.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
All right, then. Why do professional builders and remodelers choose Nuts? Seems to be reason number 151, which must be Nuts boutique selections. And maybe the big box prices? Ah, yeah, best of both worlds. Just look at the big box. Oh, maybe not. So why should you choose Nuts? Isn't it obvious? Nuts. Kitchen, bath, and flooring.
Like you, my hands are everything to me. But I was diagnosed with Dupuytren's contracture, and it got to the point where things I took for granted got tougher to do. Thought surgery was my only option. Turns out, I was wrong. So when a hand specialist told me about non-surgical treatments, it was a total game changer. Like you, my hands have a lot more to do. Learn more at factsonhand.com today.
When you're sick, so sick your heart hurts.
And your mind races.
When you think that you might have cancer, and then they tell you,
you have cancer.
And you just want somebody to say,
it's gonna be okay.
This is where we treat cancers that were once thought untreatable, where success is measured in lives saved and dreams fulfilled. UW Health, remarkable medicine, remarkable care.
Auto show concept cars are great, especially when affordability is part of the concept. Announcing auto show savings time at your local Ford dealer. Now get great deals on Explorer, Escape, EcoSport, F-150, and more. Every Ford is proudly built with tomorrow's technology today, all with huge savings. Now that's a great concept.
Now lease Fusion for just $199 a month. Or choose FlexBuy and get 0 for 66 financing plus $3,500 when you finance through Ford Credit. Whatever it takes.
Takes for our customers. You told us you wanted quality, but at a lower price, which meant we needed to do a better job at offering better prices. So we committed to doing just that. We've lowered and locked down prices on many of the top leading brands, matching some of the lowest prices around. You'll now find price declines in just about every aisle and on your favorite products. Our hot deals, well, they're even hotter and are some of the best prices you'll find anywhere. And for our fuel saver fans, we have even more deals to help you save on gas. At Hy-Vee, we'll do whatever it takes to help you save like never before.
I'll do what it takes.
Hockey postseason well underway, and the top-seeded Verona boys facing off against the Sauk Prairie Co-op tonight. They are the number 4 seed, and a very healthy crowd at the Verona Ice Arena tonight. Wildcats scoring 7 goals in their last game, but the Eagles setting some big goals of their own here. Nick Mass, a sophomore, gets one through the goalie's legs, tie game at 1. Later, Parker Plock, his shot deflected, tries again, but this time Ryan Ritter there for the help and the tip-in. Verona takes the 2-1 lead. Then later, check out these moves from Kale Rufinock. What a snipe! Here, the senior captain with a hat trick tonight. Wildcats win 6-3 the final, and Verona will play Edgewood this Saturday in the sectional final. The Crusaders beat Sun Prairie in overtime tonight. Well, back-to-back games in any sport, especially the NBA, pretty hard to do, but both those games on the road even more tough. But the Bucks are the best team in the league for a very good reason. Drake in the house, 2 championship belts with him. We're annoyed by him, it's fine. 117 out of the last 18 games Toronto did. Pascal Siakam hits the 3 early, led Toronto Toronto with 22 points. But the Bucks ending the half on an 11-1 run thanks to the Greek Freak driving in for the layup there. And a big second half. Giannis snipes it over to Chris Middleton for the lay-in. Middleton with 22 points. And then later, Dante DiVincenzo. Check out that move. Ooh, the reverse lay-in. Bucks up by 11. They hang on to the lead, 108-97, the final. Big Ten action tonight between two ranked teams, Iowa at Michigan State, both in that five-way tie for second place with the Badgers. That's Julius Marble, the freshman with a bucket and one. Later, Spartans playing some good defense, too. Fast break bucket for Rocket Watts, game high for 21 for him tonight. Close game, though. Iowa fighting the home crowd. Luca Garza led the Hawkeyes with 20 points, 9 rebounds, but Michigan State hangs on at the Breslin Center, 78-70, the final. So that changes the landscape of the Big Ten just for today, though. Michigan State now alone in second place, and that crowded area is now third place. Tomorrow night, Rutgers and Penn State will play each other, and Maryland and Minnesota will face off at the Barn. So Badgers fans, this is a little sacrilegious, but maybe cheer for the Gophers tomorrow night, okay? NFL Combine underway, and we'll see how hard a few Badgers have been training. Amherst native Tyler Biotish will get the stage tomorrow. The Badger center left a year early after winning Wisconsin's first Remington Trophy in program history. Also on deck tomorrow, Brown Deer native Zach Bond. He had some legit numbers during his senior year, 53 solo tackles, 12 and a half sacks, and one interception. Finally tonight, spring training game in Florida between the Yankees and Rays. Check out this catch over here. The hop, and he didn't just catch it, he did it barehanded, one-handed barehanded. Like, ow, he's just bowing. He's doing it for the crowd here. His hand's probably like really, really red. But hey, maybe think about getting him on a roster, right? We'll be right back.
Look at that.
I have a feeling if he has social media, that will be on his social media.
No, we saw him slash the ball from the left side.
For over 40 years, Kitchen Idea Center has partnered with discerning contractors, designers, and architects, bringing their clients' vision to life, featuring Plato woodwork cabinetry. Kitchen Idea Center, designing for you and your life.
Find your style at Menards with 11% off Patriot Lighting.
Or you could add stylish storage with 11% off all Dakota shelving.
Insulate and save big on energy costs, plus get 11% off.
Create your dream clear view kitchen with 11% off.
You'll be floored by our vinyl plank flooring. Get 11% off all of it.
Whatever you're working on, you'll get 11% off now at Menards.
Save big money at Menards.
Ish Monroe, Mark Zona, Pete Maynard, Tommy Kimo, and other fishing experts will be speaking at the Wisconsin Fishing Expo, February 28th through March 1st at the Exhibition Hall at the Alliant Energy Center. Same great show with a hot new look. Now with even more booths. New Kids Fishing Bingo for the first 500 kids per day. Over 300 booths. Hundreds of boats priced to sell. More gear and tackle than ever. Go to WIFishingExpo.com for details. Kids 12 and under free.
I grew up working in my family's supper clubs. This is where it started with us as far as the fish that we serve at Culver's today. We source the finest cod and batter each fillet by hand and always cook it to order. That beautiful golden brown color and flaky on the inside. The fish fry is a Midwest tradition. It's about coming together. It's families, friends. I love bringing this tradition to guests everywhere. Mom and Dad would be proud. Welcome to Delicious.
Attention! The Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services has officially authorized new benefits that Medicare Advantage plans may include. To get the benefits you deserve, you can call the Medicare Coverage Helpline.
Hi, I'm Joe Namath. If you're on Medicare, this is important information. I called the Medicare Coverage Helpline and they instantly looked up my coverage. In this one simple call, they offered to enroll me in a plan that includes rides to medical appointments, private home aides, doctors and nurses visits by telephone, and even home delivered meals. The plan also includes dental, vision, hearing, and prescription drug coverage, all at no additional cost.
Don't delay. Call to see if the new benefits are available in your area.
Call the number on your screen now. It's free.
Call 1-800-662-3800. That's 1-800-662-3800 now.
Searching for a new kitchen? Look no further than Kitchen Ideas Center, a trusted kitchen design center for over 40 years, featuring Plato woodwork cabinetry. Kitchen Ideas Center, designing for you and your life.
This portion of News 3 Now is sponsored by the Wisconsin Lottery, reminding you to please play responsibly.
Gary's here with a final check of your forecast.
Any fuchsia left?
Not a one.
Really?
Go check it out, Gary.
See, you can see the snow down to our south, generally just clipping far southeastern portions of the state. A little bit of light snow in Racine and Kenosha counties. Temperatures over the next few hours generally dropping into the mid-20s. Not a big drop-off in temperatures. And then look for high tomorrow of about 30 degrees and maybe a couple of flurries tomorrow afternoon. After that, the cold weather sticks around through Saturday, and then we'll see a warm-up with highs in the 40s for early next week. Rain Monday and Tuesday may be ending as a mix of rain and snow late Tuesday night and Wednesday, but then temperatures back in the 40s for the end of next week and into the following weekend.
Well, we're getting there. Gary, thank you. Thanks for joining us for News 3 Now at 10.
Do something good, and we'll see you back here tomorrow.
Now, a WISC-TV editorial with editorial director Neil Hyman.
The guilty verdicts handed down by jurors in the sex crimes trial of Harvey Weinstein feel historically significant in their precedence. A message has been sent. A legal line has been drawn in the sand. The question that must be answered next is if the message has been received. Some stories about the verdicts used the term sexual misconduct rather than assault or rape, suggesting ongoing uncertainty over how to describe the behavior, to a degree minimizing its impact. For all the impact the hashtag MeToo movement has had, it is still subject to backlash. And of course, there is the current occupant of the White House and the attitudes and behaviors those like him accept and enable. Nevertheless, prosecutors in New York charged crimes once thought too hard to prove, and jurors validated that decision. Sexual assault is a crime, and perpetrators can be held accountable. If not culture change, it's a step in the right direction.